Hi friends, this is Bharat. Today we are going to talk about async await keywords in .NET Core. Async await helps you to execute many tasks at once. It is most helpful for long waiting tasks which blocks your code, while these code markers create state machine to run tasks concurrently. It is similar to reading a magazine or book while you are waiting for a flight. Instead of allocating separate time to read, which will prolong the completion time. Please remember, task does not necessarily represent an additional thread. If you await a task, you return the control flow to the caller of your method until something sets the task as completed. If you start a task via task.run, then it is executed on another thread from the thread pool. We will now see a quick demo with a code snippet and debug it to see the results in action. Let's jump right in. We have a simple method, method 1, 2, and 3. The main method is going to call method 1, and method 1 is in turn going to call method 2, and method 2 calls method 3. Method 2 and 3 are decorated with async and await keyword. There is a long running task in method 3. Let's see how this executes. The control goes to method 2, which in turn passes that to method 3. And you'll be able to see that the start long running method has executed. Then we have the await keyword encountered. So the control goes back from the long running method all the way back to method 1. So you'll be able to see that method 1 is done message appears. You may wonder why is that method 2 is done has not appeared yet. It is because we have another await keyword in the while calling the method 3 as well. Now once this 5-second delay is done, the control will resume to the next line. So the method 3 is done will be executed. Okay, then the control goes back to method 2 is done and it is completed. So the order of execution is 1, 3, and 2. Now, for some reason, what will happen if you want to execute method 2 first? In that case, you can simply remove this async await decorators. And now let's see how the control goes. It goes to method 3. Then it encounters a task delay. So what happens in this case is the control goes back, since it is awaiting here, the control goes back to method 2 is done and method 1 is done. Okay, so the first method that gets executed is method 2. And after the long running task is completed, the method 3 will be executed. So the order is 2, 1, and 3. In such an action, you will also want to pass a return value to the caller. In that case, so let's say you want to return an integer in the long running method. So you will have to pass that integer as task of t. And you can catch that in the caller method. Let's see it in action. So the execution is the same, but this time after the long running method is completed its execution, you will see a return value passed to the caller method. So the results is available in method 2. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And remember to visit my GitHub repository for more code snippet. Thanks for watching.